I think obviously with a new defense, we need to learn what to do. And that's so important in the back end, especially with the communication side of things. The guys knowing what to do and knowing our terminology, what we're going to use for this defense, and communicating that down. And then getting lined up and running to the ball. That kind of becomes an afterthought whenever you're second-guessing yourself and you're not sure what to do, which understandably so, we kind of looked that way beginning of spring this past year. So now that we all know what to do, it's coming together nicely.
We're concentrating on paying attention to detail. I mean, last year we was very structured on our coverages and things, how they wanted us responsibility-wise as far as defense. But this year we paid a lot of attention to the small details and the little discipline and things that we needed to overcome. What we needed to overcome this year as far as taking a bigger step this year in the season?
I think we got a lot better. I think we look like a completely different secondary than we did whenever we walked into fall camp, which is what you want to see. And we told the guys there at the end of camp last week that, hey, man, we don't have to play East Carolina tomorrow or the next week, but we got to be ready the next week. So understanding that it's a process and we're improving every day and learning from our mistakes and not making the same mistake twice. So I think the guys have done a good job of that.
It was a lot of change, especially with the verbiage. We had to learn a whole different language as we communicate as with the offense and everything. But I mean, it's been a lot. It's been a lot. We had to understand and get the focus on.
I think obviously Fred Payne and Trey Morgan, they do a great job for us, not only on the field but off the field. Whenever they speak up, which isn't very often, it's powerful, and the guys listen. They stop what they're doing and they listen. There's more substance to a man's word that doesn't speak all the time. So that's been good to see. It always helps that that's two of your better players that are your leaders. And they don't have to say a whole lot. They lead by example, and the other guys see their practice habits every day, and that's always helpful to a coach.
I embrace it well because the program is growing. And as you see, as me and Trey and other guys, we're the only two veterans who had the experience, who've been on the field for a while. So it's kind of up to us and lead as example and show the young guys the way and set the tone for them so they see how it's done in the new era of Western Carolina.
I'm not so much into the numbers and stats and all that good stuff, all the interceptions and things that maybe the media might like. I want our guys to play well within the scheme. Do our jobs really well, and when there's opportunities, capitalize on those opportunities.
Success is something that is a lot of the great discipline things that's done well. It's the little things that's stacked on top of each other that's going to make the bigger picture. Like I tell the guys all the time, it's almost like a big puzzle, and some of them are the key pieces to the puzzle. We got the main picture figured out, but we still missing spots and places in order for us to see the bigger picture. Coach Gideon, he means a lot to us. He pour a lot of passion into it. He comes out with a lot of energy, and it's something that he wants to do. He tells us all the time he wishes he can get out there and play with us, but he can't. He know he got strapped it up. And Coach E, man, he's a big inspiration to us just to hear about the things he had to overcome with his playing days and see how much that we should put on the line and never know when your last play is going to come.
Because I am such a young coach, I don't have a whole lot of my own experience coaching-wise to draw from. So I do have to draw from those guys that I've learned from, and I've been so lucky to learn from some of the great defensive minds and football minds in general in my young career. And then obviously I do draw from my playing career, the things that I was able to pick up on and the ways that I learned and all that good stuff. So all of that, a combination of playing and the coaches that I've worked for, that all plays into it.
The biggest thing we've been focused on is technique, being consistent in all play, eye control, just doing the little things as a defensive back. You know, you get caught on that Allen a little bit and things, you know, you got to revert back to your technique to be successful.
I think the camp went good. We put in a lot of work. I feel like we worked a lot harder than what we normally would. But, like, you know, the coaches came in, they pushed us just to see where we were mentally.
And the leadership is awesome. I mean, you got two guys, Fred and Trey, who played a lot of ball here, and they've been successful being here. So they the vocal leaders in here. And the guys said on film that they take the coaching seriously and do everything that we ask them as far as technique and things like that. So it's been help for those two guys when the coach is not around. You know
you have a lot of young guys. Me and Fred were really only two old guys in the room. So, of course, he's going to do what he's been doing. But guys like Marvin Tillman, Mikey White, those guys have been continuing to step up as well.
not being far removed from the game and being able to translate the things that I've seen and those guys being able to see me as a coach actually play not too long ago, it kind of helps and they can see the techniques and things that I'm talking about actually by seeing myself and Coach Gideon doing it.
He's a cool coach. He's laid back. You know, he like to sit back and observe and just let you play. That's the type of coach you love. You want to play for, but he's going to get on to you when you mess up as well.